Hey there, Will here. I can't wait to tell you about today's Bible story. Do you remember what God did when Daniel and his friends obeyed him? That's right, God gave them wisdom. In today's story, Daniel used that wisdom to help out Babylon's king. Let's see what happened.
Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, had died. A few other kings ruled after him, and then Nebuchadnezzar's grandson became king. His name was Belshazzar.
King Belshazzar had a big party, a feast. He invited 1,000 people, and there was plenty of food and drinks for everybody. King Belshazzar asked for gold and silver containers. The containers had been taken from God's temple in Jerusalem. The king and his guests drank from the containers. But the containers from God's temple were not supposed to be used for drinking at parties.
Suddenly, a man's hand appeared at the wall, and the fingers began writing a message on the wall. The king was very afraid. His face was pale and his legs shook. The king didn't know what the message meant. "Bring me the wise men," the king ordered. "If anyone can tell me what this message means, I will give him gifts and an important job in my kingdom." The wise men came, but none of them knew what the message meant.
The queen heard what was happening, and she came into the room. "Don't be upset," she said. "There is someone in Babylon who is wise. He will know what this message says." The queen called for Daniel to come to the palace. "If you can tell me what this writing means," the king said, "I will give you gifts and an important job in my kingdom."
Daniel didn't want the king's gifts, but he agreed to tell the king what the message said. First, Daniel reminded the king about what happened to his relative, King Nebuchadnezzar. "God made Nebuchadnezzar great," Daniel said. But Nebuchadnezzar thought too much of himself, so God punished him.
King Belshazzar had not learned from Nebuchadnezzar's mistakes. Belshazzar did not love God. He loved himself the most, and he worshiped false gods. Daniel said, "This message on the wall is a message from God."
Then Daniel read the message. The words were, "Mene, Mene, Tekel, Parson." Daniel told the king what the words meant. "Mene" meant that God had counted the days of the kingdom. Belshazzar wasn't going to be king anymore. The next word, "Tekel," meant that God had given the king a report card and he had failed. The word "Parson" meant that Babylon would be split up and taken over by two enemies. That night, God's message came true. King Belshazzar was killed, and a new king named Darius took over the kingdom.
God used Daniel's wisdom to get the king's attention about his pride. The king acted like he was better than God. God humbled the king. Jesus humbled himself by dying on the cross for our sin. God raised up Jesus and gave him honor. When we humble ourselves and trust in Jesus, God will raise us up too, and we will be with him forever in heaven.
God really got the king's attention by writing on the wall. God's message to the king of Babylon was a warning. The king had been proud. He loved himself more than he loved God. What does God do to the proud? God humbles the proud. God took away the kingdom of Babylon, and the king died.